Class. So, remember how we've been talking about different and non-traditional forms of art this week? Well, today we're going to learn about a very special artist who creates beautiful art that's very different from what we might think. The artist we're going to learn about today is Julian Beaver. Raise your hand if you've ever heard of him before. Okay, great. Well, what people tend to find the most interesting about this art is the material that he uses to create it. His art is created using sidewalk and chalk. Before learning about Mr. Beaver's art, we'll first learn a little history about him. Julian Beaver is an English chalk artist and architect. He has been creating chalk drawings since about the mid-1900s. His art is extra special because when it is viewed from a specific angle, the art becomes three-dimensional. He has worked all over the world, including Belgium, France, the Netherlands, Germany, Austria, Denmark, Australia, and even the United States. Although he creates oil paintings and collages as well, he's most famous for his 3D sidewalk art. The first thing we're going to look at is his technique that he uses for this unusual art. Then we'll take a look at three of his artistic creations, which are Batman and Robin to the Rescue, The Rescue, and Swim. Now let's get started. Beaver's art is created using a technique called anamorphosis. Can anyone tell me what this means? Beaver uses anamorphosis by first using his architect background and designing his art on paper. After that, he uses his camera to make sure that by viewing the picture from a specific angle, the picture is going to look three-dimensional. He says that the camera only lets you use one eye, and therefore, your mind is sort of playing tricks on you, which is referred to as anamorphosis. Now let's take a look at three of his works. The first one is called Batman and Robin to the Rescue. What do you guys find interesting about this picture? It appears as though Beaver is standing on a small ledge of a tall burning building, but in reality, he's only standing on pavement. The fire in the building and the people below are merely tricks of the eye that we're able to see only from this angle. The next piece is called The Rescue. How is this piece different from the last one we saw? This piece actually looks upside down. The reason for this is because it was meant to be viewed only through an inverted mirror. Beaver liked to experiment, and one day he realized if you could make things go down in the pavement, you could also make them look as if they're coming out of the pavement. This piece was the result of that. The last piece that we're going to be talking about is called Swim. This is one of his most famous drawings. In this picture, we can see the drawing from two different angles. What's different about the two pictures? In one, we only see colors and a flat dimension. In the other, we're seeing it from the correct angle, and therefore, we see the picture three-dimensional. Now that we've seen a different form of art that I'm sure a lot of you probably hadn't seen before, in Beaver's words, my art is for anybody. It's for people who wouldn't go into a gallery. It's art for the people. Now that we've explored this type of new art, we'll actually be trying to recreate it ourselves. Remember what we learned in math about angles? This will be a great time for us to use those techniques again. I'm passing out some paper so that we can sketch out some ideas for homework, and tomorrow, I will bring chalk and we will go outside and try to create a piece just like Mr. Beaver's.